some people they don't in the end become a registered architect, but they are still doing well in other career options in the architect field. Can you share with us, you know, what other options that you can do?
Architect is a very wide range of career opportunity. We are having quite a lot of opportunity there. The reason being very simple, because architect, when you train yourself as an architect, you must train yourself from the very basic to the top, A to Z kind of things. So you know how to handle people. You have a very creative mind, okay? And then you have to know how to so-called manage certain things, management. Okay, so in that sense, you can actually basically work from any field. This is my personal opinion. And then, if you are graduating as an architect, of course, like Damon said just now, then even you are a registered architect, not categorize yourself, you must become an architect too. You can be the businessman if you would like to in the development, okay, in the designing construction, because you have to handle all the people. Just imagine if you are handling one major project, you basically have to handle in a meeting at least 20 persons. So from the 20 persons in that room, you have a multi-discipline of business in that room itself. Means from the consulting, from the developer, okay, from the suppliers, construction. So those are the major aspect, so-called category of business in the society.
So it's not just about drawing something.
No. It's more than that. What you can expect from you can so-called design your own cafeteria, and then do a business in the F&B and relax your life.
Some do sales. They're selling building materials.
Yeah, that is a very good business aspect actually. A lot of friends of mine actually in the business of those things, and then they are selling very good in goods, supplying to the construction company developers. Even if you are very good in model, you like to do modeling, you can set up your own modeling company, and then there will be a very good aspect also. So not necessary, just limit yourself, I must become an architect, not necessary.
Right now, Alpha is offering a 3 days, 2 night educational trip to all the students who sign up for our coming intake. That's the one reason is because we feel that it is good for students to be exposed to different places.
The reason being, you need to go outside and see. Like Damon and Charles, actually, I believe they graduated from overseas also after diploma.
Utah.
And Daniel is going ahead to overseas also. They have the chance actually to look outside the world. The reason being, in Malaysia, we are in tropical country. So in the building setting, it's actually more to the tropical setting architecture. Okay, we call it as tropical architecture. Okay, and then if you go overseas, different climates, different culture, you have to look at the different building types. Okay, so that is the point that you have to see outside world, because actually it cannot be like what kata bawah tempurung, isn't it? Actually, just looking at your own world is not enough. You have to look outside. And then that's a good chance, because during the 3 years of study, actually you should go every year, organize the trip actually to anywhere else. If possible, will be free, that will be back. On top of that, I give you one opinion. It's actually not just sightseeing tour.
Yes, sir.
It is actually, you just go there and then look and nothing out from there. You must at least actually can train yourself with a basic. Means actually I go there with a purpose. Why I look at this building? It must have a reason behind. You must know the history of the building. You must know how to so-called the ancient people, how to build those kind of building. Because architect in the very ancient world is called master
builder. Your experience from your previous company help you to be prepared to set up your own?
Yeah, definitely. As what Charles mentioned, the architecture life in real life is very tough, and especially in Malaysia. So as what Jenny mentioned, I handle about 10 projects at once. So you need to, actually your life is just working and go back sleep, that's it. So you need to travel outstation projects, so you need energy, you need focus. All this is train us well to become.
So I I said, you must have a passion in architecture. That's why when you work overtime or you work into the design, it doesn't matter where the hour don't count anymore.
It's not just in architecture you have to work hard. I think in every field you have to work hard.
Of course. If you look at Dr. Universe, every call you have to attend to it, isn't it? Lawyer, actually, you have to find all the facts. You have to look at all the books, which I hate it. I like to look at the pretty pictures, okay, rather than look at the pretty words. So that is me, okay. And then, that will be the fact of the works. No matter which field you are in, you must have that mentality in mind. Especially if you want to work, if you want to the boss like you, you must work pretty hard. Of course, boss will squeeze you to the end of the last bullet. But there's a good chance for you to learn. There's a reason why you have to learn. It's not a simple life in the world. Okay, you have to learn from throughout the hard way. Actually, so but that is a very treasured experience that you got. Okay, and then you can equip yourself when you want to move out in future. Okay, and then of course actually one person handling 10 projects, all those kind of things, actually that will be a good experience for you, because actually from how do you handle the project, you will build your own confidence level into it. And then when you really want to start up your own, that will be all the equipment that you got.
Thank you. I think they want to know the difference and why come to a diploma instead of going for a foundation and a degree.
I think my opinion, like Damon's, just now Charles said, you still have the breakpoint. Actually, not necessarily go through the whole study in architecture. You can have your break in center at the middle. Try out the outside world first, then come back again, do the work. I believe what is Daniel doing now, I think it's a very good way, because the experience in the real life is more important. I will feel that after a few years of studying, get yourself actually go to the market for a while, look at the real world, and then come back again to do a study. You will refresh yourself. Like why after my personal experience is after 8 years of working hard in the market, actually I feel tired also. So I come out and then I try to give back, and then I give lectures, okay, give back to the student what I have learned from my past year experience. So from there, actually I equip, refresh myself, and then okay, I seriously move into the business again. So it must have a break. Don't go and study very long, like 6 years, then after that, quickly work for 2 years, quickly go for the registered architect, actually you kill yourself.
But that's the Malaysian mentality, man. Everything must be fast, cepat.
Cepat mati lo.
As we're wrapping up, I would like you to leave a word of encouragement, a message for our audience. You know, how do you enjoy and be successful in the architecture
line? I think probably if you're really thinking of doing architecture, make sure you have the passion in it, because without passion to really push you through, I think it's quite impossible if you don't really love the subject itself. Because like what everyone mentioned, it's really quite a tough line to walk through. But if you really love it, I mean, it's rewarding in the end. So have the passion before you really choose this line.
Okay, thank you. Damon, any words of encouragement for our guests?
Okay, I wouldn't say word of encouragement, but I would say the right attitude to succeed in this subject, in this architecture. I remember during our time, the senior, the lecturer always say architecture is architecture. So you have to equip yourself really well and make sure you have a right attitude and discipline in doing all your work, studying or completing all the projects. So with that good attitude and right discipline, I don't think is a, and that is possible, I would say. Yeah.
I would say just do it. Why you wait? If you think this is actually a good way of life in designing especially, and then you are not sure whether I'm going to the technology, work of life or art, all those kind of things, I will feel that why I choose architecture, because it's sit in the middle. you're good in technology, you're good in art, combine it together, go for it. That is my own.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Please give them another big round of applause. And,